haram. But out of necessity, you allow it to do it. You understand? No, it allows it. So why are you taking a picture of her passport? That's what I'm saying, necessity. Yeah. That's my point, yeah, that's my point.
There is also now necessity.
No, of okay, hanging. Yeah. I'm saying, because he is speaking about out of necessity, can become allowed. As one of them, in order for you to have a passport, you have to have a picture on it. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
This is the queen on the money.
That's my point, yeah, my point. Yeah, same, I agree.
سيدي ولا الدروس.
وحدة وحدة أخوة.
الناس تستفيد من الدروس العلمية.
الشيخ بن باز رحمه الله, he said videos, he said, I used to say it's haram. But now when I see the benefit of it, I said it's allowed. Look to the fiqh of Ibn Baz, rahimahullah. He said, if we say picture is allowed to take picture for the sake of your passport, because it's going to benefit you, what about something will benefit the whole ummah, which is videos being recorded to spread out the whole ummah?
Medical textbooks.
Yeah. I agree with that anyway.
About painting. Now, in criminal sphere, in criminal law,
yeah,
there is people who are qualified in painting. They can paint you as you are, you know.
Yeah.
Some say that this is necessary to recognize the suspect.
Yeah.
A woman get raped, a woman get stolen, okay? There is no CCTV.
Yeah.
However, they can describe his malama.
Yeah, yeah.
Facial characters.
Yeah.
The police brought someone who is knowledgeable in painting. He has the art. He paint according to her descriptions. And oftentimes, they, you know, wanted. You know the picture wanted?
Yeah, most wanted, yeah, wanted, yeah. Well,
this is necessity. Why?
Yeah.
He's a criminal. He can do...
I mean, we agree with Akhi. This one, I think he doesn't agree with you.
This is painting.
Out of necessity.
This is you can do.
Yeah. على الرسم عنده.
Criminal who is
that's like a dog.
Yeah, yeah, he agrees. Yeah, he agrees. Okay, no, look, he doesn't disagree with you. He says he agrees out of necessity it's allowed. For that's example, you have a passport. For you have to have a picture. However, you
then. We are not on itlaq.
Yeah, but he agrees with that.
No,
out of necessity.
No.
For a passport.
It's a must. You can have a
passport. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, he agrees. But the other point is, no, yeah, yeah.
Choose not to have a passport.
Yeah, but in order for you to travel now, you have to have a passport.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
That's
what I'm saying. If you come back, Allah. But this issue, the ulama differ about it. So we should not have like
a... Next time, some people tell you, what
are you talking about? ما في فايدة حتى جيت انت العين وخليت
الحمد لله بيتوفي الله
my reaction
الله
حافظ وإياك ها
I ask him, are you a Muslim? Say, I'm Muslim, why are you hiding?
هذا تو انا شوية
like testing people.
You want to yesterday?
No, no, I don't.
You don't watch it?
I don't watch this stuff.
You should watch it.
No, why?
It's in the Holy Land.
Which Holy Land?
Watch it.
Where? In Medina, Mecca?
In Saudi.
Saudi is not all of his holy land.
No, the holy
the holy land is Medina, Mecca, akhi.
Is it?
Yeah, Noqba Aqsa. I mean, Saudi is not holy land. Najda, and not every hijab part of hijab is holy land. Al-Muqaddas, the sacred places, even Aqsa is not sacred. Bayt Allah al-Haram, and Majid Nabawi. نعم. But we still call it holy land, Mubarak. نعم. But not every part of Saudi is Mubarak by Islam, no doubt about that.
You should watch every, you should go.
I'm not going to watch it. Why am I going to watch it? I don't watch people boxing each other.
Because that's what happened in Muslims' country.
May Allah guide them. What we want to do? May Allah help them. There is no permissible, it's haram, no doubt. But we ask Allah to guide them. I was speaking about that. What I was saying doesn't mean because there's certain things that happen in Saudi or Algeria or Morocco. Then what we do? What we, me, okay, you're telling me. What do you think Shamsi can do? I have my own problem with my house. I'm trying to raise my daughters upon Islam and the Sunnah. And you're telling me to resolve a problem in Saudi?
It's not resolved. It's not resolved.
That's what I'm saying.
But it's a munkar, isn't it?
It's a munkar and we don't agree with it.
It's a munkar.
I mean,
somebody swearing, fucking and...
Astaghfirullah, don't swear, there's a woman here.
He's been swearing.
Yeah, yeah, it's haram, no doubt.
It's a holy land.
I mean, they, wait, you think... what about,
and they're having a club.
Why do you think Saudis don't swear?
They're having a club.
But Saudis swear, Zakhi.
They're having a club.
No, Habib, listen. Saudis themselves, some Saudis...
Everybody, yes, he says, thanks Jesus, my God,
Billah.
In the holy land.
It's not holy land apart, brother. Holy Land is Medina.
The Prophet was alive.
Alayhi salatu salam.
I don't know what they're going to do.
No, of course, it's haram.
What is he
going to
do?
But
I don't know what he's going to do.
But listen carefully. You, Saudis, but you have to listen to me. Saudis, Some Saudis do swear as well. So why he can? But you talk about swearing in the land. I understand, but it's haram, it's not permissible. That is a munkar. May Allah guide the Muslim leaders to fix it. Is that enough? What do you want to do? What do you want to do?
I don't want you to do nothing.
So what are you telling me then?
Because people are hiding from this thing.
And hiding from it? What?
Big major thing happening in the Holy Land is in front of the whole world, and everybody says, yeah, that's not my problem. That's not my problem. I'm here to give da'wah. Give da'wah and lie about people. Some people, like I was watching Ali's friend, a black man, what did he say? There was an LGB lady standing in front of him. He says, in the Quran, it doesn't say nothing about homosexuality. You can have your sex with your boyfriend in your house, nobody would say anything to you.
Who said that?
It's permissible. Who? The guy who's with Ali Dawah.
I think you misunderstood him.
There is a video.
What's his name? The brother Dawood.
There is a video. You can watch it and you see if I'm...
No, but he's my Muslim brother. So even though I don't agree with everything he says or something, but as a Muslim, I don't believe he says that.
That's a lie. That's a big lie.
No, I don't think he said it.
It's not in the book. He said homosexuality is allowed. It's not in the Quran.
No, maybe he's talking about the ruling of the punishment.
Was actually like a scholar as well. What did he say? The guy asked him, can you have a non-Muslim as a friend? He says, yes, with no doubt. Can you have a non-Muslim as a friend?
No, you're not Muslim. We're not allowed to take a non-Muslim as a friend.
That's it.
Yeah. You can't. You have to give them advice, be good to them. But friends, even you cannot have Muslim sinners as a friend. Yeah, because why?
So give them that.
Yeah. You can't. Because why? You have to have a friend that wants to help you to worship Allah. But that doesn't mean you should not be good to them. You should be good to them. Because that's why some Muslims...
Hear me out.
Some Muslims, they mix between, no problem, be good to the non-Muslims. Take care of them. You can welcome them to your house. Look out. But taking someone as a friend, we're not even allowed to take some Muslims who are sinners as a friend, let alone non-Muslims. Because if you're non-Muslim as a friend, devil is going to be with you all the time. And you need to pray. He doesn't pray. Either you're going to drag him or drag you. You understand? So you have to have Muslim friends who are, or even if our Muslims, they are upon worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, because the Sadiq.
You need to give them da'wah.
Inshallah ta'ala. No, maybe there was misunderstanding. I think you. Alaykum as-salam wa barakatuh. As-salam. Yeah, alhamdulillah. I think may Allah guide him. Yeah, but I do agree. Sometimes some Muslims, some stuff they say, they have to be careful. Huh?
Sugarcoat
Islam and yeah. It doesn't mean, because sahib has a meaning, friend, he has a meaning. Yeah, or it has a meaning. I can't tell you you're going to become my friend. When you're my friend, I want someone to help me to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you going to help me to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You know, so I'm going to take you on as my friend. Even if he's a Muslim and he's a sinner, don't take him. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, Al-mar'u ala deeni khalilihi, falyandur ahadukum man yukhalil. The man is upon the religion of his friend. So if your friend's atheist, he's gonna try to, he will try to drag you. And it happened, there's a Muslim brother contacted me. His brother had an atheist friend. He tried to give him da'wah. What happened? It was the other way around. The Muslim became doubtful. You see?
Atheists
being in doubt and they have knowledge, but no problem. If you have a non-Muslims, that if you know some non-Muslim neighbors, like a non-Muslim neighbor, you can have a neighbor that is a non-Muslim. You have to take care of him, has a right over you. But so, friends,
I don't love them.
You love only for Allah's sake and hate for Allah's sake.
There is a hadith I can't remember now in Sahih al-Bukhari.
You love good for them, because even love, because you know people try to play with words. Love is special.
Love
is special.
From heart.
You know, yeah, from heart. But you see here, they say, I love you, you don't even know him. Yeah, Muslims will love goodness for non-Muslims. You know, we love goodness for everyone. That's what Islam teach me. Islam teach us to love good for the for everyone, and that's why we're here to call them, that's why we're here to call them to Islam. Because the true goodness, when you become a servant of your Creator, and you worship your Creator, that is the true meaning of goodness. When you recognize the Creator, and you understand your purpose in this life, that's the meaning of goodness. But it's true, some people will try to water down Islam. You know? Like, you know, just may Allah guide us and guide them. Alhamdulillah. What's the time I think I have to go? I have to go, you know? Because I need to...
لا الوقت معك الوقت
لا لابد امشي يا اخي. Yeah. I mean, if you have questions, because we can't just stare.
أنا عندي أسئلة كثيرة لكن ما أريد.
أنت ما تريد تكون في الكاميرا يا أخي. بارك الله فيك. ما تريد تكون على المباشر. على المباشر.
لأن أنا كثير عندهم يدعون هنا كثير. يدعون.
Without knowledge.
أيوة ما أعرف عنهم.
Yeah, yeah.
عندهم طريقة الفلسفة.
الفلسفة.
كثير.
تخريف خرفوا.
أيوة ما يروحون على الحديث والدليل.
Yeah. الحمد لله صحيح. الله السلام والعافية. أيوة
لكن في سؤال دريت يا شمسي. سؤالي أنا هنا إيش؟ إن كيف الشخص؟
What kind of glasses are you wearing, my brother?
Yeah.
What kind of Versace?
Yes.
ما شاء الله.
بارك الله فيك. بارك الله فيك.
Dean, Dean making you wear Versace.
Say again.
The Dean is making you wear Versace.
The Dean tells you to beautify yourself. Alhamdulillah.
Beautify yourself.
Yeah.
But do you know what Versace stands for?
Huh?
You know what Versace?
I don't know what it stands for. What
do you wear, brother?
Well,
what? You wear Versace.
You wear in Nike.
No, I wear Nike because I'm not a person of Dean.
Are you Muslim?
I am Muslim.
So who said the only?
No, no, can I ask?
No, no, brother. Wait, wait, wait.
What Versace?
Brother, do you know that stands for on your hat?
No, no, no. I don't care what it stands for.
Why? It's halal for you. No, 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 brother. There's no person of Din. No, no, brother. There's no person of Din.
Yeah. Wearing a Ralph Lauren, my brother.
May Allah bless it.
You should be ashamed of yourself wearing these kind of brands because these brands promote sex, promote a lot of it, and you're a person of shame.
What about the tattoo?
Yeah.
I don't. I'm not religious.
But you're Muslim. No, no, brother. Okay. No, step by step.
No, you're gonna. Versace. Ralph Lauren, let's see the commercials, let's see all this. Why would you wear some all these brands?
Okay, so you finished, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
You finished.
Me,
no, no problem. No,
oh, good one.
No problem. No problem. Akhi, no problem. Step on. No problem.
No, no, no.
No, Akhi, if Allah me speak. Allah me speak. Allah me speak. He accepted. And now, as a Muslim, no problem. You can finish. Now, can you show me in the Quran?
No, I'm not showing you about the Quran. No. I'm telling you what the Quran stands for.
So who's the criteria, the Quran or
you?
I wear it because I love it. Happy, take care of yourself. That's it. Because he doesn't want to listen. He wants to justify the haram he's doing. He's wearing a god. You're wearing a god. You're wearing a shirk. It's shirk. It's shirk. Look what he's wearing. Hypocrisy. Brother, take care of yourself. Take care of yourself. Take care of yourself. Take care of yourself. Don't worry. How are you guys? You okay? Are you Muslims?
So you cannot preach Islam and you're a person.
Are you, where are you from, brother? English, mashallah. What about you? You know Muslim? You Muslim as well? Alhamdulillah. MashaAllah. How are you doing? You know, all of us, we have our own struggles. You know, we try our best. May Allah help us all.
You know? What's
your TikTok? Huh? Oh, you see the TikTok videos? Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. What country you love? Are you from England? Where are you from?
America.
I'm Arabian. My grandma is Moroccan.
Alexandria.
I'm Algerian. But my father is half Algerian, half Moroccan.
I'm Muslim,
yeah, it's from my grandma, she's Mujda. Rahimahullah. This is the first time here?
I seen it.
Is your first time here?
On YouTube,
in Hyde. No, I've been down a couple of times.
A couple of times, actually. Yeah. What do you think about it?
I was saying earlier, the trouble with this kind of environment is people aren't really coming to discuss, they're coming to just to make their point. Consequently, when you're saying something, they're not really listening.
Yeah, yeah.
They're just waiting to be able to say their piece too.
That's true.
So I don't know how much like real dialogue there is between people where people have actually found anything out, yeah, as opposed to just having their chance to.
That's true, but sometimes you have very good conversations. Like sometimes you, for example, just now. Someone become Muslim.
I know someone.
Yeah, yeah. And Jamal, forget.
Leave, I know, yeah. I know.
So many times I have good conversations, but also many times some conversation is like, oh, literally me, I go home, I take paracetamol.
Yeah.
Well, I go back with a headache, you know? But sometimes you have a nice conversation. Just you have to choose who you're speaking to.
We're not making,
yeah,
money.
And you have to be wise. When you see, like, I'm speaking to him, just I left him. There's no point. Because why? It becomes like personal. He's telling me why I'm dressing like that. I don't know if you want me to just bean bag or I don't know what you want me to put, you know? But I agree with you, Akhi.
And there's probably, for you know, some of the people around there must be like undercover, like, do you know what I mean?
Shake your hand. Sure, I agree, 100%, we'll lie.
Yeah.
Some people, you see them, they have nowhere, they disappear. Then, like, I remember not long ago, someone came to me asking me very weird questions. I said, brother, I don't even know you.
Yeah.
Who are you? What's your name? Where do you live? You know, everyone knows where I live, I know where I'm from, which mosque I've been coming here for 15 years. That's true. And a lot of them are coming here to just cause tashwish, we say, like, just to cause troublesome.
Hey, I'll jump fucking say something.
Yeah, that's true, brother. Nice to meet you, Akhi. I'll let you go, inshallah.
Yeah,
may Allah bless you. My sister, assalamu alaikum. Take care of yourself. I have to go, inshallah. May Allah bless you all. See you come in Jannah Firdaus, inshallah. We will see you again. Wallahi. Mushkila, you know, let me clarify something. Wallahi, it's very, it's needed, you know.
Because they keep saying that.
You know, this.
In common.
Every time I wear something, someone tell me, this goddess. I wear something else, this is another goddess. So, akhi, the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, something we have to clarify. This mentality, I'm an imam, I should not, or I'm a teacher, I should not wear haram, but usually wear haram is okay. That is not from Islam. That is a satanic way. So basically, you don't wear nice shoes, but I'm gonna wear nice shoes. You know, subhanAllah, he's wearing, like for example, some people say Nike is a goddess, yeah? He's a Greek goddess. He said, no, don't worry about me. I'm not a da'i. But where Allah, that's what I was gonna ask him, where Allah said, layman Muslims do haram. Muslim teachers, no haram. Where are you getting that? That's from what? That's what they call it, psychologically, you try to comfort yourself even though you know you're doing haram by saying, I'm not a da'i. Enjoying good forbid the evil, not only for the scholars, it's for everyone who is able to do it according to his ability. With wisdom, no doubt. You understand? So alhamdulillah, Allah bless me, I dress nice, alhamdulillah. And that's from Islam. Even some back home, they think, if they see you dressing nice, say, no, we're dressing. And Nabi alayhi salam, I'll tell you this, yeah? Ali ibn Abi Talib, when he sent Abdullah ibn Abbas to speak to the Khawarij, what was the first thing the Khawarij told him? About his garments. They say, what is this garment you're wearing? Like, why are you wearing like this? Because why? Khawarij, you know, they were some old, you know, tear-up garments. He said, why are you wearing this? He said, I saw someone better than me wearing something better than it. I saw Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam wearing something better than it. Allahu Akbar. So, and for Prophet sallam, some dress, they were from Yemen. And they were not Muslims at that time. They were not Muslims. So this conditional he tried to make, justify himself. That's why I said, don't speak to him, is a waste of time. Not every time you wear something, they do this, they do that, you know. Allah, this is just the tanattu. And Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, halakal mutanatti'un. The Yahud in Medina, they said Allah's hand is stingy. But yet Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was doing business with them. So some Muslims, akhi, he won't justify what haram is doing, but akhi, you should not wear this, you should not wear that. Akhi, focus on yourself, ya akhi. If I follow people, I'm not going to wear nothing, ya akhi. One guy said to me, I should not wear qamis as well. I said, what am I going to wear? If you are a child, don't wear trousers. That's why, you know, it was a waste of time speaking to him. May Allah bless you all. So, dress nice, beautify yourself, rather, and Nabi said, Allah, inna Allah jameelun, yuhibbul jamal. Allah is beautiful and He loves beauty. And Allah loves to see His blessings upon His servants. Alhamdulillah. Barakallahu feekum.